Hey everybody, welcome to My 80s Memories. This episode, I'm going to be talking about this album here, Adam and the Ants, Kings of the Wild Frontier. It's kind of an interesting story with me because, you know, I had heard about Adam and the Ants. I had seen their 45s in the new import singles bins, but I didn't know what they sounded like. You know, they looked back in those days. You know, we're talking the late 70s. During their post-punk years, they look like they might be sort of a dark punk band or post-punk band, and I didn't know what they sounded like. Then I started reading these reviews when Dog Eat Dog came out and Ant Music came out, and you know, they were talking about this you know, tribal Burundi beat, and it just sounded really exciting. So I went to Licorice Pizza like the week this came out domestically. Now, the domestic version had a couple different songs than the import version, but generally speaking, they were the same album. So I went and I bought it, and oh man, I hated it. I did. I honestly hated it. But my friend Chuck Reddick, who, you know, one of my best buds, still he's my friend, you know, even today, he said, "Hey, I'll buy it off you. I love it. I'll pay you." So I took the money. And you know, he took it home and just fell in love with it. You know, after like a day or two, I'm thinking, God, there must be something I missed. Totally must be something I missed. So I went on, you know, my next paycheck. I was working, I think, at Jack in the Box at that time. And I went and I bought another copy. And I took it home. And then, yes, I didn't like it. And... You know, here it was. The album had been out for 2 weeks. I was already on my second copy, and I just didn't like it. So I sold it to another friend, got my money back. You know, I hadn't heard it again, you know, when Chuck played it, and I hadn't heard it when I sold it to my other friend. But again, you know, I was just reading all this stuff, and Chuck was just raving about it. And I thought, well, I'm going to give it a third chance. And yeah, third time's the charm, because that's when it kicked in. I just don't think that I was ready for it, because I think I, you know, maybe I was looking for something like The Jam or Undertones or Squeeze or whatever, and what you got here was completely, absolutely different. Now, Adam and the Ants on this album, they take everything from sort of primal rock and roll to glam, and then they add their own weird and wonderful elements, create, you know, Adam provides, you know, most of the backing vocals, or at least he arranges the backing vocals, and they're completely unique to Adam and the Ants. Absolutely a killer record. You know, when you think of this album, of course, like I said before, you think of Dog Eat Dog, you think of Ant Music, you think of the title track, Kings of the Broad Frontier, but there was so much more to this album than that. So much depth. I mean, behind, you know, Adam's very unique vocals, you know, and the layered backing vocals, there's the rhythms and just some incredible stuff going on there. Great songwriting, a very unique flavor. Now, of course, at this point on, I had to go backwards, and I'm not going to get too far into depth, but I discovered the Dirk Wears White Socks album, which was a completely different sound. In fact, this was closer to what I was expecting Adam and the Ants to sound like. You know, when I saw like the picture sleeves of the singles, and it was dark. It was very post-punk, but it was also very creative. Now, this first album eventually got repackaged. They took off a lot of the songs, added a bunch of singles and stuff, and it came out as this album, Dirk Wears White Socks. Oh, before I continue, let me tell you, Adam Ant eventually brought in Malcolm McLaren as his manager. And like one of the first things he did was kick Adam Ant out of the band. He took the rest of this band and created Bow Wow Wow. So Bow Wow Wow has a link to Adam and the Ants. But Kings of the Frontier, you can get, you know, the original pressing, you know, American, UK. There are different CD pressings as well. In fact, here's a single disc, a remaster, with some different bonus tracks. But this one here is the 2-CD edition. This contains every song that was on the American and the British version, plus bonus tracks. And it's just very unique. You know, when I say that there was that primal rock and roll and that glam stuff, that's there. But it doesn't come out like, oh yeah, that's glam, or oh, that's rock and roll. He takes everything and just brings it all together and creates something new out of it. So it's really fantastic. Now, there was one more Adam and the Ants album, which was Prince Charming, and then he went solo under Adam Ant. Oh, another thing I wanted to tell you is the bass player on this album, Kevin Mooney, he went off to form the band Wide Boy Awake, and they put out some great singles. They never put out an album, and I've always wanted some company to put all of that stuff together on one disc. But I highly recommend anything you can get your hand on by Adam and the Ants. I mean, Dirk Wears White Socks, like I said, is a little darker. But the thing is that he never made the same album twice. Every album that he ever put out is different. And that is what makes him fascinating. Now, it's all distinctly Adam Ant. It's very unique voice, very unique songwriting style. He's an artist that was always evolving. And this is where it started for me. I highly recommend, if you haven't heard this record, Kings of the Royal Frontier by Adam and the Ants. Definitely get it. I have so many memories attached to this. And obviously the very first one is the fact that I didn't like it first time I heard it. And I sold it to my friend Chuck. And that's still something we talk about today. That's it. Remember to like, comment, share, subscribe. Let me know what you think of Kings of the Wild Frontier by Adam and the Ants. And thanks for watching My 80s Memories.